Recorded Books presents Ways to Play by Lyn Miller-Lachmann, illustrated by Gabriel Alboroso, read by Mark Sanderlin. Other kids tell me I play with toys all wrong, like bossy older cousin Emma, who comes over with her little sister Violet to show me the right way. She says my way is boring, but I'm going to show her. My cousins make a lot of noise and bounce from toy to toy. I can play at one thing all day long, like tearing up old newspapers and piling them into a mountain. If I run out of toys, I can still play. They invite dolls and stuffies to a tea party. But if I line up my dolls and stuffies by size, I know which ones fit on the chairs. It makes more sense that way. They color inside the lines. I sharpen my crayons until they have the pointiest points and leave behind squiggly spirals of wax. Points and spirals make beautiful pictures.
"That's not how you're supposed to do it, Riley," says bossy Emma.
"That's how I do it," I say. I take a book from Mom's shelf, open it to a picture that looks more like mine than hers.
"Cool," says Violet.
But bossy Emma says,
"So what?"
The room feels too hot. "I'm going to let the dog out," I tell them. I wink at him because it's easier to look into dogs' eyes than people's, and I know he will help me show them how we play. I throw Charlie's toy. He brings it back, almost. "Here, Charlie," my cousins call, and beg some more. But he shakes his head like he's laughing. He runs in circles around the yard, and we chase him until we all fall down laughing. "See," I tell bossy older cousin, "there are lots of ways to play with toys." And everyone's way is the right way. Author's note. When I was a child, I played with toys differently, and it often meant I played alone. I looked for patterns, lining up my dolls and stuffed animals by size or color. When other children came over, mostly the daughters of my mother's friends, because I struggled to make and keep my own friends, we battled over the right way to play. They insisted that my way was boring. I stressed out over their disruption of my carefully created patterns. This didn't mean I didn't engage in imaginative play. I used my doll collection, of course, with all the dolls of the same scale and type, to invent elaborate stories that reflected my efforts to understand the world around me. I told stories to my brother at bedtime and tapped them out on a typewriter my mother gave me for my 7th birthday. Imaginative play with my dolls was central to my life well into my teens, long after my peers had given theirs up. Sometimes I played with children who were much younger than me as a result, even though my parents and peers made me feel ashamed of what they called my immaturity. It was only in adulthood that I found out I was autistic. It answered a lot of questions about my childhood and why I was not like the other kids. It has taken me additional years to recognize that what I saw as struggles and difficulties were actually a source of joy to me at the time, and prepared me well for becoming an author of books for children and teens decades later. All young animals use play to learn how to live in the world, whether it's a hawk fledgling learning to hunt by chasing sticks on the ground, or a human child building towers with blocks. Unique ways of playing lead to unique ways of seeing and solving problems. In addition to my own experiences, this book was inspired by the life and writing of Dr. Temple Grandin, the noted animal behavior scientist and autism advocate who has written about her experiences as an autistic person. The scene with my character tearing up newspaper to make a mountain is drawn from her childhood, which I wrote about in my chapter book biography, She Persisted, Temple Grandin, Philomel, 2022. I hope that Ways to Play creates an appreciation for the different ways that neurodivergent children approach play, There is no right way, only the need for us to see and understand each other and what each way can contribute to a shared, fun experience. Lyn Miller-Lachmann.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.